Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have 7 topics to cover, so let's get started. You can now get, edit, and delete tasks assigned from Google Docs, documents, or chat spaces using the Tasks API. When listing all tasks, you will have to add the query parameter show assigned with the value of true to include the assigned tasks. The task resource returned by the list method will contain an assignment info field which identifies where the task was assigned from. Multi-select menus and columns are now generally available for Google Workspace add-ons. You can now call the Chat API to make a Google Chat space discoverable to specific users in a Google Workspace organization. To specify the users in your organization that can discover and join a space, you create target audiences. A target audience is a group of people, such as specific departments or the entire organization. To make a space discoverable to your target audience, include the Access Settings object in the space resource as part of your Chat API request. If you want to stay up to date with what's new to the Google Workspace platform, I invite you to subscribe to this YouTube channel. When building chat apps using Google Cloud Functions, Cloud Run, or any system that supports authentication via ID tokens, you can now authenticate requests using Cloud Functions or Cloud Run, or authenticate requests with an app URL ID token to verify that the requests to your app come from Google Chat. Let's say your chat app's function logic is implemented using Cloud Functions. In this case, you must select app URL in the authentication audience field of the chat app connection setting and make sure that the app URL in the configuration corresponds to the URL of the Cloud Function endpoint. Then you need to authorize the Google Chat service account as an invoker. To do this, go to the Google Cloud Run page in the Google Cloud console. You can now import a space from other messaging platforms and allow external users to join that chat space. To achieve this, set the external user allow field to true when creating the space. The Google Drive API now supports the drive.meet.read-only scope. This restricted scope lets you view Drive files like recordings or transcripts created or edited by Google Meet. We are introducing a feature that will allow Google Workspace admins to restrict which URLs app scripts and sheets can source external content from. For app script projects, when the admin specifies an allow list, the URL fetch service will only work for URLs on that list. We recommend you speak to your Workspace admin if your app script project uses the URL fetch service to avoid any service disruption. Please let us know in the comments section below. Which of these new features are you most excited about? Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in next month's news video.